The next concept in averages is the method of assumed mean. Now this concept is based on the understanding of sum versus deviation. Alright, now see, there are 5 values given and you have to find out the average of these 5 values. The first method again is the sum method, where we use the formula average is equal to sum of values divided by number of values. Alright, so what is the sum of values? It's a very simple school method. You add these, right, and you divide this by the number of values, that is 5. Alright, there's nothing to explain. I hope this one is clear. Okay, now coming to the deviation method. Now, why am I calling this assumed mean a deviation method? Reason being, look at the formula. Average is equal to assumed mean plus average of deviation from the assumed mean. What does xi denote here? Xi denotes an individual value. A is the assumed mean, right? So the difference between the individual value and the assumed mean is the deviation. So you are finding the sum of deviation. This sign means summation. You are finding the sum of deviation and dividing it by number of values. So what is this? Average of deviation, right? Added to the assumed mean. All right, let's try to work this out. Let us take the assumed mean as 130. Now, what value can you take as the assumed mean? Is there a restriction? No, there is not. But ideally, I take a value which will give me lots of plus minuses and make my calculation shorter. Alright, so if I take this as 130, 120 is 10 less. Alright, 130 is 0, 140 is 10 more, 110 is 20 less, and 150 is 20 more. Right, so now sum of these divided by 5, this gets cancelled, this gets cancelled. Now this became an easy one, but what remains is the final answer. So I hope this is clear. So when not just in quantitative ability, even in DI, when you have large data sets, so for example, you have a data given where 3 different cities and 12 months rainfall data is given, and you have to work on average and all, you have to find some averages, right? This concept works because you take one value as the assumed value and you make the others plus minus smaller values, you know, you save time like this. I hope this is clear. Thank you.